Hi, my name is Sally Flower from Home Sanctuary and Australia's first trained KonMari consultant. Today, as part of the Sustainable Living Week, we're going to be talking about how you can use the KonMari method to declutter your home and spark joy. Now, the KonMari method was created by a lady called Marie Kondo, and she wrote a book called The Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up. The book has sold 11 million copies worldwide and been translated into 40 different languages. There are three key reasons that make Marie's method of decluttering and organizing so successful. The first reason is that we declutter by category and not by room. We declutter by category for two key reasons. The first reason being is that when you pile everything in one big pile, you get a real visual idea of the amount of stuff that you can have, and sometimes it can be a bit of a reality check. The second reason is it makes it easier for us to make decisions. We only have a limited amount of decisions that we can make in one day, so rather than asking our brain to make decisions between a pen and a book and other objects, it's much easier for us to ask simple questions like, which t-shirts do I need? Which jeans do I need? Which stationary objects do I need? So that's a key reason that we declutter by category and not by room. The second reason the KonMari method has been so successful is that this notion of sparking joy or finding joy. And what Marie Kondo means by sparking joy is that everything that we have in our home should make us feel good. We should want to use it, we should be excited to use it, it should spark a happy memory, and we should be proud to own it. Anything that doesn't feel like that, we should thank and discard. The other reason why sparking joy is so successful in helping us declutter is that it makes it easier for us to make complex decisions. The third reason that makes the KonMari method so successful is this notion of KonMari folding or vertically folding, especially for things like clothes and linen. We stack everything up so it's standing on its edge, which enables us to see what we have, know what we have, and use what we have. So often we have things hidden in the back of cupboards and piled on top of each other. Folding this way enables us to make the most of our space and use the things that we love. Ideally, you would spend some time thinking about how you want your home to work for you. If you live in a big family, I'd recommend having a chat all together. And also, think about the stage of the life that you are in. Do you have little kids who you want to be able to run around and make space for them to play? Are you in a time of your life where you're doing a lot of studying and need a lot of quiet time? Or maybe you just want to be able to lock the door, downsize, and head off on holiday whenever you can. So think about how you want your home to work for you. Even ideally create a little bit of a mantra and come back to that idea every time you're decluttering and you get off track. There's a wonderful link between sparking joy and sustainability when it comes to using what you have and loving what you have. I'm a big fan of enjoying everything you own and using what you have, even those sentimental pieces. And I know sometimes we have those items in our cupboards that we don't want to use in case we break them, but I really encourage you to get out and use your sentimental pieces. Take this tea set, for example. It's from my grandmother, and she never took it out of its box. It was only ever used at special occasions for Christmas. When she passed away a few years ago, I received a 68-piece dinner set that had almost never been used. Now I like to display it in my cabinet and enjoy a cup of tea occasionally and think of her. I highly recommend using all of those items in your home, using and reusing and sparking joy whenever you can, because that is the key link between sustainability and sparking joy. And when we start to love what we have and use what we have, we remove that focus from accumulating more stuff to bring us joy and finding joy in the things that we already own. And that's the key connection between the KonMari method and sustainability. Using what we have, loving what we have, less on accumulating more. And that's the key to having a sustainable home.